VAT is going to affect your companies and everything like that. To keep running the business in the VAT era is an art. And make sure that you don't make mistakes and your company doesn't make losses because of you. That's why I prefer that the accountants and whoever handling the tax and VAT should have complete knowledge of VAT. So he or she, when dealing with the authority or implementing VAT in their companies, doesn't make mistake and the company doesn't suffer losses in case of penalties or other things like that. Now, what is known and what is unknown as per today? We look at the scenario that in VAT, what is known and what is unknown. As you can see, that known is that GCC already they agreed that VAT is going to implement, and only two countries have agreed to implement VAT from 1st January 2018, that is Saudi Arabia and UAE. Rest have to follow by the end of 2018, and the other countries, four, must get their VAT ready by 2019, 1st January. Various feasibility study have been conducted that what will the impact of VAT in each country, how it will work. An introductory rate, they have decided to introduce the VAT with a 5%. It may go up eventually, it will go up once these things are there. And excise law is already in place in UAE and KSA. VAT law has been published in UAE and Saudi Arabia, both places. Like, registration for VAT have already started in UAE and KSA. What is unknown? Very interestingly, unknown. There is uncertainty, number one, of basic food item, which they declared 94 food item will be exempted from taxation. Still, the list is not there. And they have said that for the time being, the VAT will be on all the items, regardless of, you know, there will be no concession given on VAT. So, for the time being, VAT, it means the VAT on 94 item is also there. There is no exemption. Now, detail of healthcare to be exempted, that they said that healthcare will be exempted. Which category of things will be exempted? Operation, which, because already in a definition they have told that only the essential healthcare items will be exempted. Like you have operations, heart bypass, other things, any cosmetics that you want to uplift your chin, make your nose thin or your eyes big. So these are taxable. And what are the medicines? Which medicines will be taxable on VAT? So it is not still unclear. Refund on tourist. Now, initially, when VAT was introduced and they have declared, they said that VAT will be on tourist also. There will be no exemption. It was in the awareness program, they already declared. But later on, now they said that tourists will get the refund. But how they will get the refund, like in UK, on the airport, where, what, nothing have been announced. Executive regulations, you know very well, executive regulation last week was announced and now again withdrawal. Draft is a withdrawal, it's not there in the website. You print them and they said that there is typical error and there is error, so they have withdrawn that one. So there is still now there is no executive regulation. Now, treatment of free zones, this is very important question. You see that they declared initially that there will be no VAT unless the regulation is there on the free zones, unless a specific regulation are there. After that, they did an awareness program just recently, I think last month, in which they said that designated zones will be there and designated zones has to get registered. Designated zones means free zone companies are registered. But still, it has to be explicit, that regulation telling and notifying every free zone authorities should, you know, issue notification that their companies has to get registered. Only DMCC till now have announced that all the companies in DMCC have to get registered. Then external audit mandatory or not mandatory? This is very, very important question, that is internal audit mandatory for VAT or not? First, if you are going, you have done somebody of any one of you have done the registration for the company, will notice that it was their financial statements required. Then they said financial statement, which financial statement? Again, this executive that last 11 month and 1 month estimate you have to, for the time being, you can, you know, stamp and sign and upload the statements. But later on, when will the audited statement will be required or not? Coming back, this question have been raised so many times and at different levels. I give you an idea. When you are incorporating a company in DED, according to memorandum, you are signing and attesting that you will appoint auditor every year and you will provide auditor account every year. When 2015 amended this memorandum and company law came, it made sure that your accounts have been audited. Otherwise, it was supposed that 2006, your license will not be renewed unless you provide them the audited account. But 2016, they give relaxation and all the license of the mainland companies were renewed. Later on, it was supposed to be 2017 that audited account has to be submitted, but that time also they give relaxation. Now, the question is arising that if the company is not preparing account and not getting audited, how they will ascertain the authenticity of the figures. So on that matter, they have to give their recommendation, they have to issue regulations, laws. Apart from there, just keep it bear in mind, there is no oversee board or regulatory authority which is looking after the quality of audit reports. Like in other countries, in your country, there may be some Security Exchange Commission and other like UK Security Exchange, they are checking that audit reports are up to standard, they are following IFRS and all the requirements have been fulfilled. But till now in UAE, such body is not there.
But there is, I'm sorry for interrupting, there is in the company's law a point where it's mentioned that the company should be audited. And after 3 years, I'm not sure, after 3 or 4, it should be changed.
Changed auditor. This is new 2015 company's ordinance. It is there, that it is there. And every company has signing that when they are being part of it. But ultimately, nobody is asking them to provide this financial statement. So these statements are not there. And the problem started, I will later on tell you what is the reason for that, that VAT is not a, such a huge thing or big problem. But there is unclarity. The things are not clear. The laws is not fully, you know, backed by things which has to be clarified. So that's the problems arising, that there's uncertainty. Now rates, you know that there is exempt, some details of exempt are residential property or food staff should be, will be exempted, zero rated education, healthcare, residential property, new investment and precious metals, local transport.
We will send you this presentation.
Ah, okay. Thank you.
Standard rate, jewelry, second-hand car, marginal scheme which they already announced, financial services, standard rate on fee income, marginal base income exempt, Islamic banking product treated as equivalent and conventional insurance premiums. Now coming back, there are 2-3 more in very important things. That you know that in UAE is the second largest place for gold sales and jewelries in the world. In the world. Now there is a problem is that they have announced that the VAT will be on jewelry first of all, and the gold jewelry complete piece. It means if you are selling bars, it is exempt. They will miss if you are pure 100% gold, it is not covered under VAT. But if you are selling a jewelry in which you have made designs and everything, the VAT will be on the whole price of the jewelry. So it means the price will go up by 7 to 8 grams per. And the competitiveness of gold jewelry in UAE will go down as compared to other part of the world. Here huge buyers are there. The Gold and Jewelry Association are trying to contact FTA. They have sent their request that the VAT should be only on the making charges. But till now it is not finalized.